hi friends, thank you for joining us today, and thank you Bipasha for taking the time and sharing your journey with us. Just to give a brief and quick introduction, Bipasha Datta, again, I have written my notes to avoid mistakes. So Bipasha Datta is one of our students in Applied AI course. Just the last week, she joined Infosys as a business analyst working on data science problems in their Azure machine learning team. So congratulations, Bipasha, on making this successful transition to a data science role. Thank you. Very good. So again, this was the first machine learning interview that she ever attended, and she successfully cracked it, which is a big kudos, which shows your focus and attention to detail. And as far as your background is concerned, you worked as an intern for a while, and also you worked as a content reviewer at Amazon for a while. So cool. So again, thank you very, 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 very importantly. Thank you for sharing your journey, your pointers, and your appreciation for the team over email. I'll touch upon some of those points, but in this discussion, we'll try to focus more on your journey, how you learned, how you transitioned successfully, so that students who are very similar to you can benefit from your journey and take inspiration from it.
Sure.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So could you tell us how you learned data science and machine learning, and how you prepared overall, whether it's by using our course content, our mentorship, our emails, assignments, whatever it is? Could you give us a brief overview about your learning journey?
Yeah, sure. So I was aware about machine learning, data science stuff. I worked with Amazon, as you said right now. And I was in Bangalore at that time. And I joined a course in Bangalore. So it was a 6-month course. So I was aware of this machine learning, data science, AI stuff. But unfortunately, I could not study properly that time, or I could not understand the concepts properly. So there was a big gap in between. But then when I decided again that, you know, I have to move to data science, that time I was looking for some courses online, and fortunately I came across this course where, you know, it was written that 100% job guarantee. So that was the main reason why I was interested in this course. Later on, I saw a few videos, some reviews, and the reviews were, let me tell you, so good that I had to enroll for this course. And I enrolled, I think, in March 2019, last year, right?
Last year,
March. So, yeah. So at that time, I enrolled for this internship also. I got an internship offer from Cytel. So I could not do. So I again extended the course. And from this March, again, I extended the course. Yeah. And then the lockdown started. And I knew this is the time when I can get a huge amount of time to study. Then I went through all the videos. Initially, I was thinking.
So your preparation actually started only in the March of this year.
Yes, this March I started. Initially, I thought, you know, I'll go through the videos and then do assignments one by one. But it was taking a lot of time for me, in spite of being aware of what machine learning and all that stuff is. But the way you were teaching, it was so deep and so useful, and it was taking a lot of time for me to understand
their own learning rate. So that's perfectly
okay. Yeah. So then I thought that I'll do one thing. I'll just go through the theory part. I'll go through all the videos first, and then I'll go for the assignments.
Okay. That's so, one strategy that some of our students follow. Yes.
Yeah. So in the month of March, I started, and by August end, I finished. So before August and before finishing the deep learning part, I started applying at various companies. And in the month of August only, I got this call from Infosys. So I did only one assignment. That's the EDA assignment.
Because you must finish the content and then do the assignment.
Yes, okay. Yes. So that assignment was also very difficult for me to do at first when I saw the problem statement. But then eventually, I'll tell you one thing. I'll also like to share it with people that even if you feel that it's difficult, just do it. You will get through it. That's the only thing I would like to say.
Yes, especially
it looks very difficult.
Yeah, the first assignments might take a little more time because they're just getting used to that way of thinking. But slowly things will smooth out and things will become faster. That happens to everyone.
Yeah. So first day it was like, I did not understand what to do, how to do. And second day I completed the assignment.
Very good.
And so I submitted.
Couple of days. Yeah. Very good. Very good.
Yeah. And in the month of August, I got this call, first call. And then there were three rounds. And last week, I got the offer letter.
Okay, cool. So I also remember answering some of your questions via email. Yes. So you said, after you mailed us, I started checking because I remember you sending us a few sample questions.
Yes.
So that's also a very nice strategy that you followed. So can you also elaborate on that?
Yeah, so most of the questions asked to me were not from programming perspective, but they, as you also said, that they just wanted to see how will I tackle a particular problem, what will be my strategy, what the way I think to solve a particular problem. That was the main thing they wanted to focus on. And most of the things were related to finance and all. So that is not my background.
Okay.
But still, I tried to answer everything at that particular point. And then I mailed you. I wrote detailed questions and what I answered and what should be answered, if I am correct or not. So when you gave me the answer, you shared your point of view. So I was sure that, okay, this means that I am on a correct path.
Yes.
It's not like I'm completely somewhere else from what they're asking. I was on the right path. And it's just that you have to think on a bigger perspective.
And if so I recall well, most of these questions were real life instances where you had to use basic data science concepts to tackle them. Right? They were not like very hard questions. They were simple real world instances and your thought process on how you would tackle them.
Yeah.
Okay.
So cool. I remember for the last round, before that day, that there's this video on AI. Applied AI, that logistic regression, end-to-end logistic regression that you have explained.
Yes.
And I went through that video and the next day I had one round and everything they asked me was about logistic regression.
Okay. So,
that was really helpful.
Very, very good.
There were a lot of questions about finance, banking and that stuff. Nothing was related to retail and all. That was my background. So I'm actually in normal life also, I'm not quite sure about how finance things work. So I wanted to confirm if I was on the right page. And that's why I messaged you, emailed you.
Right, right.
And then the suggestions that you gave me that this question should be answered in this way, that time I felt, okay, so I got an idea that how to tackle some, if there is some domain and you don't have any knowledge about it. So in that scenario also, you shouldn't just keep quiet.
Yes.
Just because you don't know the domain. Maybe you can apply some other domain's knowledge to that thing, and you should just say something. You should just say that you can handle a problem even if you don't have the domain knowledge.
Yes.
I think that's what these people expect.
Cool, cool. So apart from this, what were the main things, because you just mentioned a while ago that one of the things that was a major focus was, given a general problem, how do you tackle it? That was one of the key areas of focus in your interview. Apart from that, what other areas were key areas of focus in your interview? Was there something related to programming, SQL or anything like that?
They asked me some questions about SQL. They asked me about the languages that I know. Like I have worked with on SAS, I have worked with R, on Python. And then I told them, I had started using Keras and TensorFlow. So I told them that I have basic knowledge about it, but I don't have, I'm not very good at it at this point of time.
But what about SQL? Did they focus more on SQL then?
Yeah, they did ask me some questions, which were, I think, because I had SQL experience before, prior experience. So those were the basic questions.
Okay,
I think.
Cool. Yeah. Very good. Very good. So what are your recommendations for other students who have very similar backgrounds to you on how to make the most of the course and how to better prepare for the real world of job interviews and cracking them? What would your top recommendations be?
Okay, so I would like to share my journey, first of all. my experiences were on and off. I was never completely continuously into the industry. So due to some reasons or the other reason, I had to leave my job. Still, I studied and I got this first opportunity. I gave the interview and I got it. So what I would like to say is enroll to this course, because the way you are teaching, Srikant sir, I don't think anybody can find any tutorial. I personally went on Udemy and on, I shouldn't name, but I personally have seen a lot of videos. I've taken a 6 months course, but still I'm saying that the way you have taught, I'm saying even if you complete the videos, you will be able to answer. It's not like you don't know anything. You will get a very good idea about everything. And even if you don't understand, you repeat the video. I'm sure definitely everybody will understand. So I'm not very good at math. So after 10th, I did diploma and then BE in computer engineering. So mathematics is not a very interesting subject for me. But the way you have taught, I understood everything. So that's what I'll say, that watch the videos. Do it. I mean, you should see how comfortable you are. Maybe you complete the videos first or do the video and then the assignment.
There are different strategies that different people take. Yes, wanted to finish the videos first, and that's perfectly all right.
Yeah. Do it. And if you get any opportunity, don't let it go. Don't let it go. For Infosys also, I was very, I was thinking that maybe I would like, how well I will perform, and I don't know, and I have never given any interview in machine learning. How will I do it? But it happened. I did it. It happened. You don't know. Maybe they'll ask you something that you know. So don't wait for anything. If you're getting an opportunity, take it.
Okay.
This is what I'd like to say.
Good. Thank you. Thank you very much. And please continue your learning journey, because since you're part of a core machine learning team, you will have a lot of scope to grow in the same organization. As a data scientist, as a machine learning engineer, you'll have a lot of scope. So all the best on your journey ahead from all of the team at Applied AI Course. And thanks on behalf of all of our team and students for taking the time to share your journey and your recommendations.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.